Good guy.
So I've had this awkward thing happen where I'll be socializing at an event and inevitably meet someone new.
Hey, what's your name?
Oh, I'm Micah. What's your name?
Dusseldorf.
Yeah. My friends call me Deucey, though.
Oh, Dusseldorf. Nice to meet you. Anyway, what do you do?
Oh, me? Well, I guess I'm a mental health professional of sorts. I do counseling.
So you're like a social worker?
Sort of. I do social work, but I'm not really a social worker per se.
A psychologist?
Well, no, I'm not a psychologist, but
A psychiatrist.
No, that's too intense. I'm not a psychiatrist, but
Okay.
Yeah. I'm gonna go use the bathroom.
Ugh, so awkward.
But it's confusing. I mean, there's just so much terminology around mental health professions, and it's hard to know how to self-identify. I mean, I don't even know what other people understand. Well, let's just clear the air right here and right now. Let's just break down these terms one by one and try to make sense of them. And just for fun, let's go in order based on median US income.
Let's go.
Counselors are people who counsel or give advice. Now, this label can be used to identify a lot of different people, including camp counselors, financial counselors, and spiritual counselors, but mental health counselors can be both licensed and unlicensed individuals. Some counselors may have little or no training at all, so you really want to make sure that you're doing your due diligence to make sure that you're getting the real deal. So, am I a counselor? Yeah, I'd probably call myself a clinical counselor just to make it sound more legit, but my license here in California is as a licensed professional clinical counselor. Life coaches are folks that motivate others to achieve their personal goals, such as changing jobs or improving relationships or setting priorities for their lives. The goal is to help that person become happier. Life coaches seem to tread that fine line right before providing therapy, and the reason is because they can't. See, to be a life coach, you don't actually need to meet any educational or training standards. Literally, anyone can call themselves a life coach. It's also a term that seems to be used exclusively in private practices. When I was looking up information about salary, I couldn't find anything on life coaches because no government agencies or companies use this title. Maybe I'm a little bit biased, but I have a problem with this title because there's no oversight or regulation of life coaches. So, am I a life coach? What do you think? No. Clinicians tend to be individuals who have at least a master's level education. It too can refer to other roles in the healthcare industry. For example, physicians, nurse practitioners, or speech language pathologists might all identify as clinicians. It also refers to therapists, psychologists, and psychiatrists who provide mental health services. Clinicians tend to be licensed or license eligible in their field and follow evidence-based practices in their area. I definitely call myself a clinician, and my current job title is actually lead clinician. Therapist is another one of those terms that can refer to other professions, like physical therapists rather than psychotherapists or behavioral therapists. But let's focus on the mental health side of things. In most states in the US, a therapist is someone who is licensed. As a result, therapists tend to have a higher degree of professionalism and ethics since they are required by their state board. But the label, particularly when you say psychotherapist, has a fair amount of bias attached to it. So, am I a therapist? Yeah, I am a therapist, and I think that's a pretty accurate term. I just wish that there wasn't so much stigma attached to it. The term mental health professional casts a wide net. This broad term was developed as a name to describe anyone who worked in the new community mental health agencies that started in the 1970s after Ronald Reagan signed law that put many state hospitals out of business. Today, it can refer to therapists, shelter employees, rehab workers, you name it. There's no real qualifications for this label except that you have to work with people who have mental health needs. Simple as that. So, am I a mental health professional? Yes, though I probably wouldn't use it as my primary title. Now, social worker is a term that I struggle with. When I talk with my social worker friends, they say, well, you are a social worker because you do social work, which is true. I do work with individuals, particularly disadvantaged individuals, to help improve their social well-being. And it is a diverse term. I mean, it can be used to describe anyone who went to college for social work, all the way up to someone who's licensed. In general, someone who self-identifies as a social worker is someone who has a master's level education. But in all 50 states, there are licensed clinical social workers, which is a formal license that's widely used in hospitals, government agencies, and other mental health centers around the US. It's a pretty well-guarded title, and in my experience, when an organization is looking for a social worker, it exclusively means someone with that license. So while I do social work, and I could call myself a social worker, I don't because that's not my license. A psychoanalyst is someone who practices psychoanalysis, which is the original form of talk therapy developed by Sigmund Freud back in the day. If you want to get more info on that, you can actually click up here to see my video on psychoanalysis. Every once in a while, when I tell someone what I do, they'll say, are you psychoanalyzing me? And the answer, of course, is yes. But seriously though, this label is reserved for people who faithfully follow the teachings of Freud and his predecessors. They almost definitely hold a master's degree and are licensed to give therapy. Psychoanalysts are more common in other countries like Argentina, and it's not particularly popular here in the US. So, am I a psychoanalyst? No, I'm not. I could become one if I wanted to, but I don't want to. Psychologists tend to be people with a PhD in psychology. Now, in some cases, master's degree or bachelor's degree holders can call themselves psychologists, but like social workers, in most states, the title of psychologist is a protected term that can only be used by people with the proper education and training or who have licensure with their state board. Psychologists may provide therapy or they may not. Some just do research. Due to its protected nature, though, I would not call myself a psychologist. A psychiatrist is a medical doctor with a specialization in psychology. They can prescribe medications after becoming licensed and arguably hold the highest level of prestige in psychology. However, due to how few there are in the United States, they tend to spend very little time with clients and focus primarily on prescribing medications. So, am I a psychiatrist? I am not a doctor, so no. Just for the fun of it, let's talk about the label shrink. Shrink is a colloquial term used to refer to psychotherapists, psychologists, and psychiatrists. Whenever I hear this term, I can't help but think about Robert De Niro as a mob boss saying it.
Well, God forbid somebody hears that I've been talking to a shrink. That's all I would need. You know, it could be interpreted the wrong way.
It's a pretty outdated and stigma-laden word, and it's one of those words that I might use as a joke to refer to myself, but if someone else were to use it, I'd probably make judgments about them, you know? Well, actually, I don't know about that. I guess it would depend on the context. Well, anyway, I hope that that was at least somewhat interesting. It was helpful for me. I feel like I was able to clarify that I more closely identify with the terms clinician and therapist in my line of work. You know, there really are more than just psychologists, and there's so many different terms for people who do mental health work. And I'm sure that I forgot about a whole bunch of them. I mean, if you thought of one that I forgot, then please leave it in the comments down below. Anyway, thanks for watching. Until next time, I'm Micah. Think about it.